President of Elsell.
Well, Mr. President. Well, this looks fine.
Thank you very much. Thank you for everything.
Up and around. Well, come in. Sit down.
You know?
Heather, we'll be in a few minutes here for a little talk between ourselves. But then there'll be two waves of press. The first one just still photographers. And the second will be the TV and the reporters. And I understand you have some remarks that you want to make.
Well, not necessarily. The ambassador wrote me here. I don't know if I want to read it or not.
Well, I was going to, I thought you might like to do that in front of the second group here, that press.
We have, the maximum we have is something like 90. That's the maximum. The minimum is only 60.
Now, of course, though, this is now a very cooler season down there.
Well, yes, it starts the cooler season. Say cheese.
Compensation for the families, the victims of the airliner,
well,
Iran?
I, from the first, have said that we're a compassionate people, and I think that we all have compassion for the families of those unfortunate people who are on that plane. And later today, there'll be a statement with regard to that.
I assume it's going to be in the affirmative.
Do you worry about American public opinion, Mr. President, being opposed to compensating the victims' families?
I think that they have tied that to our feelings about the government and what it did with regard to our people in the embassy there when the Ayatollah came in. But, and I want to make it plain that there's certainly going to be no compensation for the government of Iran or anything of that kind, because we don't feel that any such thing is called for. But as I said, I think we all can have compassion for the innocent people who were the victims.
Mr. President, we've been told that there are those who oppose this in the government on the grounds that it sets a bad precedent.
I don't ever find compassion a bad precedent.
How much money do you think it'll involve?
Don't know.
Do you have to get congressional approval for that or send a bill to Congress?
Well, there's some details about that are still being considered and worked out.
Thank you.
Cameras this way, please. You got a replacement for Meese yet?
Yes.
There'll be an announcement coming shortly on that, too.
Today?
Today or this week?
I can't give you the date and hour on that.
Sounds like you're close, though. Sounds like you're close.
Possible.
Anyone we know?
No. Thank you.
Cameron, sorry, please. Thank you.
You probably heard of him. Hello there. It's nice to see you.
Yes.
We've had a little session here with the photographers and the press.
We're leaving now, but we want to say.
Well, listen.
All who have been oppressed.
When we this say hello to all of you, we're going to have a family photo. Yes. Yes. Remember me? It's nice to see you.
And daughter.
Hello.
Thank you.
And you, My doctor?
Yes.
This is Napoleon III?
Yes.
Good to see you.
Your man, the sister.
My sister?
Constable. And this is another granddaughter.
Yes.
Another son.
Napoleon? Now, by the way, you... She's insinuating that we're fine.
Obviously taken from a little boat just offshore. But the point is that it shows the proximity of the plant. Here are the cranes for the various construction projects within the plant. But the point is that the plant is not one of these plants located way out in the boonies somewhere. It's very near miles of beach, which are very heavily used in the summertime. You can imagine what it's like up there today. And these beaches are along, what would you call them, isthmuses, I guess. Islands that sort of run along the coast, which are accessed by coal. That's speaking for myself. That's the fundamental problem at Seabrook that bears on the evacuation difficulties. Now, I want to make a couple of points, Mr. President. First of all, obviously, I think it's fair to say the others are here to argue against this executive order, which is somewhere between the Domestic Policy Council and your desk. I want to make several points, just very briefly. First and foremost, I believe that this executive order, which would have FEMA supersede the authority of states, is something that really just flies in the face of everything that you've been preaching for decades, namely limiting the powers of the federal government and preserving the prerogatives of the states. So that's point number one. Point number two is it's unnecessary, in my opinion, because the Nuclear Regulatory Commission modified its own regulations last year to accommodate these few situations where a...
President, good to see you again.
Good to see you.
Thank you. Chairman De La Garza.
President, good afternoon. Nice to see you. Thanks.
Hi. Welcome.
Our friend at Vatican.
How are you? Good to see you.
Well, why don't we come in and dig?
Secretary, you're in the chair here today.
I was worried, Mr. President, since I read that you checked which color they take, but you never said which one they bought.
Marilyn's wasting away to a shadow.
Yes, I'm doing my best.
We're doing something. talking about.
Or if I... I know it's Marlon.
Northwest and the west is formed.
Ten minutes after he went out to get started raining. And it's why nobody went probably here to run against me, because it's very bad power.
It's been a long drought, I'm sure it's gonna come sooner.
That's right.
If a drum isn't five parts, nothing is. So I know we've gotta do what is best, and I think we have to be careful to know exactly what the dimensions are. Well, pleased that we could get together today before your recess with the Democratic Convention coming up. I suspect we're all on guard against legislative mischief. So first I want to address the drought. Yesterday, Dick Ling and I met with Dick Lugar and Ed Madigan, along with Pat Leahy and Kiki De La Garza, and they put together a bipartisan bill for drought relief that sounds like one we could all support. As I told them, I want to work with them to help our farmers, and we all agree that we must do so in a responsible manner that doesn't break the budget. And I think we must avoid any possibility of sequestration. I made that plain also, that could well, you know, take back with one hand what we're providing with the other. And to get a first-hand look at the plight of our farmers, I'm going out to Southern Illinois this Thursday. And let me ask Dick Ling for his comments. And then Bob Dole, who's worked closely with the Vice President and Dick Ling on this issue, and then followed by Dick Lugar.
Thank you, Mr. President. We did have, I think, a very good meeting yesterday, and the drought, in spite of this rain that we're having here, that is rain, in spite of that, the drought is not in any way broken. Today, it's much more serious than it was a week ago.
Hi. How are you? Nice to see you again.
Well, good to see you.
Thank you. Oh, here. Thank you.
Well, listen.
Here's Travis.
Hello there. Hi. Nice to see you.
And Pam.
Hello. Now, I think with you in the middle, you on the other side, okay. I think we ought to have a family picture.
Well, wouldn't that be wonderful? Thank you.
Thank you. Well, we'll see you tonight.
We'll see you tonight.
For all you've done.
My pleasure. It's been a fun 8 years. Terrific.
Well, now, wait 1 second.
Okay.
Can't be here without some souvenirs.
Oh, wonderful.
That.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Very kind. Thank you very much.
Not as kind as you've been with all you've done.
Well, thank you.
Appreciate it.
Sure. Is Paul with us tonight? Do we know?
Paul
Laxalt.
No, he won't be there tonight.
Okay, very good.
Mary Jane Wick and the rest of the group will be there.
The rest of the game.
Excellent. We look forward to seeing you tonight.
All right.
Very good. Thank you.
Well, good to see you.
Thank you. Thanks, sir.
Thank